Now, what if a student might have varied interests? So, for example, maybe their parents are saying you have to do this course, but their interest or passion might be something else. Mm-hmm. So, could you help them understand the concept of a major and a minor?
Sure. Yeah. So, as I alluded to earlier, the U.S. education system allows students to have a lot of opportunities outside mm-hmm. of their majors of interest. And so, in the U.S., we have what's called a minor. A minor is where you're going to study a little, maybe between 15 credits and 30 credits in a specific area that's going to be outside of your major. All right. And so that can be in a number of different things. Let's say you have an interest, your parents are telling you you have to do computer science, but yet you have an interest in art. Mm-hmm. And you can do a degree in computer science with a subsidiary degree, a minor in art or music or something that you're interested in. And that allows you to take classes that maybe you are gonna brighten up your day. Maybe it's gonna be something different than what you're used to. But also to allow you to maybe experience new things and to better enhance your primary degree. So if you're doing a degree in, you know, business or something like that, you could do a minor in a language. You could learn Spanish or French or Arabic or something along those lines that can really enhance your full college education.
Sure. I'm sure a lot of students would be happy to hear that.
Yes.